But I would like to take some of these things that I'm good at and be able to create some sort of income with it. I was previously working in corporate America and I enjoyed it for what it was because I reframed the corporate job into a creative spin so I could creatively solve problems, and that worked very well for me at the time. But now I'd actually like to apply my lifelong dream of making my art, my drawings, and my writings into something that can help kids and entertain children and bring people together, like in a happy, uplifting way. Young children, little kids, elementary age children. So everything I've always wanted to do, if I've ever thought about it, is always related to children and helping children be happy. So I'm wondering if what I'm currently working on is something that I should continue to pursue, and will the path present itself?
The answer to the first question is that's completely up to you. We don't read fortunes because there is none of that. If you wish to do that, wish to pursue that, you should and you can.
Okay.
The second question is, you've also answered for yourself. The path will absolutely unfold if you allow it to. If you are working in joy toward something, toward a goal, and you believe it, the path will unfold, and it will very likely unfold in ways that you can't even imagine. Every roadblock, every obstacle is an opportunity.
Okay.
And if you're not receiving any obstacles, then you probably need to speed up the momentum.
Okay.
If that's your desire.
That is part of my issue is that I need to figure out how do I speed up momentum.
With David's changes in receiving us, he is finding a balance between his former get it done type A ways and allowing. And it is not in his personality to sit and just allow things to drop into his lap. And very often they don't. You know, your physically manifested world does require action. We talk about all of these physical manifestations, this hotel, but somebody, you know, conceived this hotel mentally, and then many other physical things happen to make this hotel materialize, physical labor. But the spark of thought was the inspiration that drove all of that. And there was a desire to reach a state of completion. So anything that you desire to do, you need to start with a spark of thought and then take every step as it unfolds in action to get where you need to go. You know, when you are inspired to write, that is when you need to write. And when you're inspired to draw, that's when you need to draw. And then you need to believe in what you're doing enough to take that next step and be inspired to get it out into the world. And usually when creative people, especially, you're all creative, but people that take on what you consider creative art, stall, it's because they don't believe. They believe they can create it. You had a conversation about this earlier. You believe that you could create the novel, but you didn't believe David, that you could get it published,
mm-hmm.
and because of the roadblocks. And he allowed that at that time to make the interest in the whole thing just go away. And that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
That was his path.
Mm-hmm.
Had he done that, perhaps he wouldn't even be doing this today.
Mm-hmm.
So it's okay. Your humanness is always okay. You should never beat yourselves up about that. But if there's something that you truly desire to accomplish, love the creating of it, you have to stop and ask yourself, okay, I loved creating it, but I created it to share. Now I've got to believe that I can share it and that there are those out there that are matched to it that want to receive it. Mm-hmm. And from there, that momentum will begin to build. That's what's going on here today. David believes that he has this ability and has now, after a very bumpy ride, believes that he can share this. And this is the beginning of that. We talk about Abraham. And what's going on with Abraham? Abraham is the same stream of source energy that is us being filtered through a different sieve. So this can be that.
Okay.
But it unfolds. This cannot be that tomorrow, because that would be a very bumpy ride to go from this to that in a week. Manifestations don't happen that quick for a reason. Things do need to unfold. Things do need to take time to materialize so that you are up to speed with it and you are ready for it. If David stood up in front of 300 people and attempted to do this, it would not be the amazing experience that we are having here with